Images can be shared across platforms with Xamarin Forms. They can be loaded specifically for each platform, or they can be downloaded for display. Images are a crucial part of application navigation, usability, and branding. Xamarin Forms applications need to be able to share images across all platforms, but also potentially display different images on each platform. Platform-specific images are also required for icons and splash screens. These need to be configured on a per-platform basis. Good day, everyone. I'm Michael, and I'm using a text-to-speech program to have a more clear speech and audio. In this video lesson, you will learn the following. 1. Create a Xamarin Forms image in XAML and encode behind using URI as image source. 2. Customize the image appearance. 3. Cache download images. Let's start with image sources. In Xamarin Forms app, we have two types of images. We have platform-independent, like backgrounds, and images that are specific to each platform, like icons and splash screens. To use independent images in our application, we have two options. We can download them using URI or Unified Resource Identifier, which you have seen before to our stack layout exercise. Or we can embed them in a PCL or portable class library. Now let's open the Visual Studio and do some coding. So here I have an image element with source set to a URI. This is the identifier of the image, so you will always get the same image. A URI image source also supports caching of downloaded images. A cache is a hardware or software component that stores data, so that future requests for that data can be served faster. The data stored in a cache might be the result of an earlier computation or a copy of data stored elsewhere. But currently, it is not supported by XAML. So we will do it in CodeBehind. Let's also define the URI source image in CodeBehind. Now let's remove this and give this image an identifier and name it my image. Save the project. Then let's go to the CodeBehind. Here, I store the URI of the image to a string data type. Then call the image element we created in XAML, the myImage. Then we create a new instance of URI image source. Inside these curly brackets, we can set the cache properties of the URI image source. This line will enable the caching. And this line will store the image for up to 3 days. The first argument in the time span method is number of days. Second is number of hours. Third is number of minutes. Then fourth is number of seconds. By default, caching is enabled. And its validity is set to 24 hours. This property makes it very easy to support scenarios like scrolling list of images, where you can set or bind an image in each cell, and let the built-in cache take care of reloading the image when the cell is scrolled back into view. Now let's run the application. If you notice, the image fits into the display area. It's because by default, the aspect property of the image is set to aspect fit. Aspect is a property of an image element which determines how the image will be scaled to fit the display area. The aspect property is an enumeration type. And it has three members. These are fill, aspect fill, and aspect fit, which is the default value. Setting the value of the aspect can be done on both XAML and CodeBehind. Now let's go back to XAML and change the aspect property of the image. Aspect fill clips the image so that it fills the display area while preserving the aspect, meaning there is no distortion. Aspect fit, which is the default value, fits the image into the entire area. And last is the fill, which stretches the image to completely and exactly fill the display area. This may result in the image being distorted. That's all for this video lesson. If you have questions, suggestions, something to add, or you think something is missing or incorrect to the lesson, please let me know. Again, this is Michael, thank you and see you at my next video lesson. Keep safe, everyone.